when we realize that Christ himself is the present. I mean, there are all sorts of things he can give us. Every good and perfect gift comes from above, from the Father of lights. That's what James tells us. There are gifts all over the word. He tells us that he poured out the Spirit on us as the gift. And it is a gift that he is a gift that keeps on giving to us through the very presence of Christ, not only around us, but in our very person. He himself is the present. And when we're brokenhearted, when we're crushed in spirit, it says he is near. He is near. I want you to hear what that word brokenhearted comes from in the Greek. I love this. I was reading Ann Voskamp's new book yesterday, a little portion of it, and she says these words, and I felt like it was so powerful. There is a strange and aching happiness. Only the hurting know, for they shall be held. It's kind of this trade-off sometimes when you've gone through a really intense time of hurting or pain or betrayal, whatever it might have ushered in the brokenness, because you've known such a closeness with God and he's been to you like your skin wrapped around you. If you were willing, and if I had been willing to be present in his presence, that's what he will always be to us. But then you start coming out of that, and it's not quite the same thing. Yes, he's present. Yes, he's there. But Jesus reserves the right to show favor to the suffering. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. That's what the word of God says. I want you to see the definition in the Hebrew of the word that translates brokenhearted. It's a verb that means to break, to burst, to break in pieces, to break down, to break up, to smash, to shatter, to bring to birth. I will come back to that in just a moment. The word is most often used to express bursting or breaking. How about that? To me, that's the essence of wholeness, that I just bring all the pieces of my broken life and my broken heart right in front of him and just present it to him. That. Did you notice that part that says to bring to birth? What in the world is that? This is why I love to look into original languages, because why in the world would giving birth have anything to do with the word brokenness? I want you to hear Isaiah 66:9 says this, and it uses a form of that same word. This is God talking. Shall I bring to the point of birth and not cause to bring forth, says the Lord? Shall I, who cause to bring forth, shut the womb, says God? Now listen carefully to what that's saying. That with a birthing, I want to talk to you right now in metaphorical terms. So stay with me here just a second. That there is a process of a breaking and a bursting forth in order to birth something or someone. Is that fair to say? How many of you in this room have actually, like, given birth in labor? And, I mean, you know what I'm talking about here. You have not had, there has never been a baby born on this earth whose mother's water did not break. I go so far as to say, without being more graphic than this, forgive me, you who are expecting your first child, just go with me here for a moment. I might also say it's not the only thing that breaks. You feel like everything from your head to your toes is going to break. But do you realize that what the Word of God is saying is that, I'm just putting this together in this metaphor. What if this time of brokenness is so that you can birth something that never would have come to you otherwise? Never, never. Now listen to me. I want somebody to get this with me, because I have a background of childhood sexual abuse, early childhood molestation. And I want to say some of you, I'm not glad that I did. Nothing about it was good. I am not thankful for that particular abuse. I don't think that's what God is asking me to be, but I will tell you what I am thankful for. That brokenness birthed a ministry, and I am not kidding. I am not kidding. I cannot tell you how often Your calling and so much of the fulfillment of your destiny will come. Your passion will so often be born out of your pain, out of what you were missing and you went to find, what you were searching for, what had broken you, what had made life hard for you. And then God comes through for you, shows you the way, and suddenly, girlfriend, you have birthed a ministry, you have birthed a calling because you went through the brokenness until something was born. Oh, I'm just gonna wait for somebody to get it. Do you see, there's nothing that can break you that God cannot birth something from. The breaking, if you are a child of God, does not get to destroy you. Nothing has the right to destroy you. Brokenness for the life of the believer and for the life of faith gets to bring forth a birth. Anybody? Anybody?